Hello, I'm Trisha from Real Fluency Now, and today I want to share some tips with you to help you speak English with more confidence. First, I'll give you five quick tips you can use now if you need to speak English with someone soon, and then I'll give you other ideas to help you become a more confident speaker in the future. Five quick tips you can use now. Number one, take a deep breath and try to stay calm. Number two, be yourself. Don't pretend to be a type of person that you are not. Number three, don't worry if you make mistakes. Number four, think positive thoughts and push out any negative ideas you may have. And number five, smile and try to have fun. Long term, you can become a confident English speaker if you do these things. Number one, remember why you want to learn English and speak it confidently. Remind yourself of this every time before you practice speaking with someone. It will help keep you motivated and to feel more confident. Number two, practice speaking out loud by yourself. This will help you find the words you want to use more quickly, and you will be able to talk more fluidly. Number three, practice English online in forums and on social media groups. This will help you with the back and forth of a conversation you will have with people offline, only without the pressure to have to find the English words you want to use as quickly. For example, I'll practice with you in the comments of this video if you say hello and introduce yourself. I also have a Facebook group you can join and practice English with either me or with other English learners. I'll put a link to this group in the description of this video. Number four, plan ahead and think of the things you might want to or need to talk about with people in English. Write out a few paragraphs and practice saying them until you can do it with confidence. For example, introducing yourself. And don't stop with just saying your name. Tell people what kind of work you do or about the classes you're taking. You can talk about your family, your parents, brothers and sisters, or your kids. Talk about your hobbies. Number five, think about things you can ask other people. That will make the other person feel good that you are asking about them and give you time while they answer to think about what you want to say next. If you need more ideas to improve your English, then please watch more of my videos here on YouTube. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel so you don't miss any of my English lessons. Goodbye, and remember, with hope, anything is possible.